Hey guys, and here we are back with another one, and today talking about NordVPN. Now, full disclosure that NordVPN, as those of you that follow the channel know, is from time to time a sponsor here on the channel, and I only accept it because they are a service provider, and the only things that I do review right over here is hardware, and I do tutorials and so on and so forth, as you guys know, so it doesn't conflict with anything. By the way, this video is not sponsored, it's just my opinion regarding a service that I use, and of course they sponsor some of my videos, so I was thinking that why not put everything together and share with the community what NordVPN is, why I did accept it, and why do I think that it's a good choice, and that's the only reason that I don't mind having them sponsoring some of my videos. Now, that being said, let's go straight for it. NordVPN is basically a VPN service, which stands for Virtual Private Network. And basically, guys, in a very quickly and simplistic way, what this does is exactly to tunnel our connection to a server, and then from that server on, our connection will be protected. And a small example is, let's say that I'm watching a movie or I'm downloading anything, my ISP will know all the data that I'm downloading, everything that I'm watching and whatnot. They have access to that data. If they use it or not, it's up to them according to privacy laws in every country, but the question is that that information is out there. On the other hand, if I use a VPN service, the only data that they can grab is the data between my computer or my connection up to the VPN server. After that, everything that I do, they are not aware of, and they can't collect any data. Now, they can see if I download 100 megabytes or if I download 100 gigabytes or 1 terabyte or whatever, but they can't know exactly what I did do or which kind of data I did download or upload. Now, this can be seen by two ways. I can do this for good purpose, like protecting my own privacy, or I can do this for bad things, like sharing my ex-girlfriend pictures or something like that, which wouldn't be a good idea, but you get the point. We can use this service as anything in life, for good or for bad, and then it's just up to each one of us. Now, regarding NordVPN itself, they have servers in 56 countries at this moment and growing according to them. There are apps for almost any platform, and this is one of the things that I do love, and I will share with you guys in just a few moments a little bit more about this. Now, the most common apps are those that we use on our commonly operating systems, such as macOS, Windows, iOS, and Android. Now, it's really easy to use. We just need to install the app on our device. In this case, I'm using the macOS as an example. Then we will need to log in just once, and then everything will be okay. Then we can select any server from the 56 countries that are available, as you guys can see on the screen, and then we can just connect. Now, we can check our IP just to make sure, but believe me guys, this just works. Now, sometimes there are services that we can only use in some countries, and this is one of the ways of grabbing that and removing that limitation. For example, if there's a service in the United States, and I do live in Portugal, and if I want to access that service, which I'm limited by geography, with a VPN service, I can do so. Now, on iOS, it will be more or less the same, as you guys can see. We just need to choose where we want to connect to, and then that's it. Just press the button and it will connect to the server. I will show you guys a few images that we also have the option to choose by country, or we can even select from several servers that we have on each country. So if by any means there's a server or two down, there will be always redundant servers, so we can choose or faster server depending on what we need. And of course, a lot of you guys use Android, so a few images there on Android, but the usage will be more or less the same. And lastly, on our Windows computers, which a lot of people use as well, fortunately, which is a great operating system, but the usage, as you guys can see, it's exactly the same. The interface is the same, just a small tweak here and there and changes from operating system to operating system. Basically, they all work the same way. Now, what we have seen so far is a connection from device to device where I can use on my phone my own VPN connection to a particular server, and my wife can use on a tablet a VPN connection to another completely server. And that can be useful in some scenarios, but there is a really interesting feature. And before, when I said that they have a lot of compatibility with a lot of hardware, guys, if you watch on screen, you can see that we can use it on almost any platform that I'm aware of, and this is one of the main things that led me to choose NordVPN, and believe that it's one of the best things that they have on their service. Now, let's say that I have an Asus router at my home, and if I want to have all the devices that I've got on my network that connected directly to that router to be protected by a VPN service like NordVPN, instead of installing apps individually on my devices, I can just use the tutorial that NordVPN has online. Just follow those steps and make my router to be protected, so every single device that I've got will be automatically protected on that VPN connection between the router itself and the server from NordVPN. And I would invite you guys to visit the website, and especially this page, which I'll show you also on screen, because there are a lot of information. And just for those of you that will be too lazy to go to the website, I'll show you guys on screen what I mean. But in terms of clean and clear instructions, for example, if we have a Asus or NAS like I do, and I use them daily, you can see that I can follow the guide and have my Asus store to be a centralized unit for the network that I've got at home instead of a router, or using on any other way, just protecting the Asus store itself, for example, as well. Now, we also can see the KeyNAP example, also Synology, which is a really well-known brand, and so many others, guys, that I would take the whole day here explaining each one of those. So that's the reason that I would invite you to check it out and see the tutorials, how good they are, how clear they are, and anyone, even without many knowledge, will be able, or too much knowledge, will be able to follow these tutorials. Now, in terms of speed tests, we will always get a little bit of a hit, nothing major in my opinion, especially when we compare to results in terms of direct connections to my ISP. And as you guys can see on screen, there is a little bit of a hit on the download and also on the upload, and this of course will depend on how far the server is from my actual connection. Now, lastly, in terms of prices, as you guys can also see on screen, they've got 4 different plans, starting in 1 month plan up to 3 years plan. And although the 3 years plan is the one that it's the most effective in terms of savings, I would say that if you are not sure and if you haven't ever tried a VPN service, then I would suggest to use for 1 month just for safety, see how you do it with it, and then if you really enjoy it and if you find that it's really useful, then you can pull the trigger on a 3-year plan, which will be the one with most savings. But guys, you just do the math and that's about it. And that is it. Hope that you guys enjoyed the video, and if you did so, don't forget that usual thumbs up. My name is Roberto George, and as always, I'll see you guys on the next one.